Joe!
Wait, what?
What's wrong?
I'm exhausted. I got like no sleep last night. Only 2 or 3 hours.
That's not enough.
Well, how much is enough?
Well, you're gonna find out, because we're on
Science the shit out of it!
So how much sleep do you usually get a night?
With the tossing and turning and waking up all the time, probably close to like 5.
Yeah, you definitely are sleep deprived.
I can't help it. It's not like I can't get into the bed. It's just like my mind is still just going like super fast. Like, oh, you shouldn't have said that. You shouldn't have done that. Like, oh, your stepdad was right. You know, you don't know what you're doing. This and that. Like, oh, the cat, my money, I'm poor and I'm unhealthy and just boom, boom, boom. Next thing you know, it's like 3 in the morning and I'm like, oh, crap.
Some people have a hard time sleeping at night because they have reduced levels of melatonin in their system. Melatonin is called the sleep hormone. Night owls, for example, don't actually start producing melatonin until much later in the night, which is why they don't feel tired until later.
I've seen videos and I've heard people brag about how they only need like 4 hours of sleep and they're like totally rested or whatever. Is there like a set amount of time that everyone needs sleep?
Yeah, so you're the average adult. Like, how old are you?
23.
An average adult between the ages of 18 to 64 needs about 7 to 9 hours of sleep a night, according to the National Sleep Foundation. So it's just, your overall quality of life is gonna be lower if you are sleep deprived.
Yes, true, but staying up late totally rocks.
What do you do late at night that's so important?
Yeah, surf the internet. I'm literally looking at a screen until the second before my head hits the pillow.
No, that's a bad thing. Having the screen right in front of your face right before you go to bed, that's... For years, scientists knew that light affects sleep, but they didn't necessarily know how. And then in 2002, they discovered a different kind of sensor in our eyes. It's called the intrinsically photosensitive retinal ganglion cells. These cells are extremely sensitive to blue light, which could explain why one study found that people who don't have electronic light in their life, their circadian rhythms, their sleep cycles, actually synced up to the rising and setting of the sun. But because we bring these phones to our bed, we're looking at this light, specifically the blue light in those phones, is sending a signal to our brain that it's daytime out, which is making us feel more alert, less tired, and ultimately disrupting our sleep.
Okay, now what about drinking alcohol before going to bed? Because sometimes it helped me go to sleep. I kind of like that bada bing a few, you know?
Drinking alcohol can make you feel tired because it actually elevates the amount of adenosine in your body, and adenosine is one of those chemicals that makes you feel tired. So it can help you fall asleep, but once you are asleep, that's where the problem starts. So we have a sleep cycle where we cycle in between non-REM and REM. Mm-hmm. And we cycle between that about 5 times a night. Alcohol blocks your ability to have REM sleep. But if you don't get REM, you're not going to feel as alert the next day. So nightcaps probably aren't the best thing.
Don't want to fall asleep fast and feel bad, or take forever to fall asleep and feel bad.
There are some foods that you can eat that will help you fall asleep if the reason you're having trouble with that is because you have lower melatonin levels in your body.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some natural foods with a relatively significant amount of melatonin. So there's almonds, there's raspberries, and goji berries actually have quite a bit as well.
Goji berry? What would be a couple of things to throw at me that I should do to like probably help me get better sleep?
The number one thing that experts always recommend is the same bedtime every night.
No, I hate that note.
I mean, you just have to set out a time. Like, you really should say, okay, 30 minutes before bed, I'm not gonna look at my screen, I'm not gonna turn on the TV, just like open a book. You can even dim
what
the lights.
What books? No, are you kidding me?
You can dim, you should also probably-
No, forget that. Screens only, it's TV or iPad or phone or laptop or some sort of monitor. That's everything now. I'm not gonna pick up a book. What am I gonna, and then read by candlelight?
Well then, continue having terrible sleep.
Fine, I will.